So DHCP, Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol. Okay. Okay, DHCP, Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol. You know port numbers? Anybody remember?
Sixty-seven, sixty-eight.
Very good. Okay. Next, what is dynamic and static? Static, manual. If you say manual, means it's a static IP. Or static means it's a manual. Manually we are giving. Dynamic. Not dynamic. It is dynamic. Means auto, automatic. Automatically we are getting an IP address. Manually means manually are you giving IP address. Okay. Next. The manual. You have to assign IP address manually. So go to adapter, right click, properties, IPv4 properties. Then select the second option. Use following IP address and give the IP address. You want to get IP address dynamically, right click properties, IPv4 properties, and select the first one, obtain IP address automatically. Obtain IP address automatically, that is dynamic. You want to see, then I will show you that one also. ncpa.cpl, let it open. So here is a VMnet 3, just for example only I'm showing this one. Right click, status, details. You will see some IP address here, and if you see here, DHCP disabled, no, means it's a manual IP address. It's a manual IP address. Okay, go to properties. IPv4 properties. So the second option is selected. It means it's a manual IP address. I want to get IP address automatically, then I have to select the first option. Obtain IP address automatically. Obtain IP address automatically means I want to get IP address from DHCP server. And obtain DNS server automatically means I want to get DNS server address also from DHCP server. If I use this one, I will assign a DHCP server on myself. Here automatically I will get it from server. So the first option will tell you get IP from DHCP. Second option is you have to assign the IP address manually. And even if you see this one, if you select the second one, general tab is there but no extra tabs, right? When I select the first one, I got extra tabs. See, alternate configuration. Okay, what is alternate configuration? If you fail to get IP from DHCP, and what to do? Alternate means if you are fail to get IP from DHCP server, what to do? Automatic private IP address or user configuration, like that. Okay, I'm not doing anything, just I'm canceling it just to show the option only. So the option is very important, and you should know how to give IP address. You know, already I told in interview time, so people want to ask you to very basic things. So then they will ask, how do you assign IP address? How do you resolve DNS address? So these are the questions, like you will get confused, right? So how to assign IP address? Oh, the steps we done, but we didn't remember, we done only once. So you have to practice very basic things also. Main important, like assigning IP address, how to check IP address, how to check MAC address. There is last time they asked one question, what is MAC address? Okay, how many bits in MAC address? It's very simple questions. Because of simple thing, we ignore and we don't remember also. So that's why we have to practice simple things more and more. Tomorrow, Thursday, right? Friday. Friday I will take 1 hour on some networking basics at least. Okay. First of all, I want this is total conjunction, right? So I want to wait. Okay. So here in a DHCP, it covers the few networking things also. Okay. So here we see. So manual. What are the issues in manual? Issues in a manual means if you have a more number of pieces, what it is? More number of pieces are there. Pieces are devices. Now we can say devices. Why devices? Because mobile phones, tablets are there, right? So more number of devices. Okay, IP address assign is assigning of IP address is more complex. Okay, assigning of IP address is more complex. Okay. Next, conflict. Why it is thing? Conflicts will occur. What is a conflict? What is a conflict? For example, for PC1, I assign some IP address 192.168. Something 1.103. PC2, I assign some IP address 192.168.1.104, for example. PC3 192.168.1.103. Okay. So everything should be in same network, right? Has anybody got doubt? Find a issue. Already I done a issue. Tell me issue. Four PCs are there. I given each PC an IP address. Now tell me there is an issue in this one.
The same IP address has been assigned for two PCs, sir.
Assigned?
Sir, 103 and 103 cannot be assigned for two
PCs. Very good. So PC1 and PC3 having same IP address. Very good. The PC1 and PC3 having same IP address, that is called a conflict. PC1 and PC3 and is a conflict. What is a conflict? Same IP address. Now the PC2 and PC4 will communicate each other, but PC2, PC4 won't communicate it to PC1, PC3, and PC1 and PC3 won't communicate it to anyone. And PC1, PC3 also won't communicate each other also, because they have a same IP address. It got confused. For example, you have a same name. I given a numbers. Then numbers also get the same. Then it is confused, right? Just like roll numbers, right? So we should not give same. That is called a conflict. Conflict possibility is there in a manual. If more number of PCs are increases, if you don't take care much, like you have to follow the sequence, otherwise a conflict may occur in a manual IP address. Okay, next. PC5, I'm giving, all right, PC5 190.168.1.106. So now tell me, what is the problem in PC5? What is the issue here? See the PC5 IP address. Is it in same network or different network? Not only one, I had a lot of issues. See, this is a 190. This is 192. So here is a possibility. People enter the IP address wrongly. Wrong IP address. Right, it won't communicate. If you are enter the wrong IP, won't communicate. So check the network address completely. Okay, So it's a class C IP address. First three are network portions. You must check the first three portions first. So both are in same network or different network. It become different network. Okay, it won't communicate. So possibility is wrong IP address sequence we are following. Wrong IP address. Because I'm following there 192, here I'm following 190. So it become different network. And people will do that mistake. For example, instead of 192.190, I seen a lot of people that one. Some people put 172.168. When I put a 192.168, they put a 172.168. Okay, instead of 172.16, they put a 168. Both are okay, but in the same network, when you are in the same network, okay, so you must give proper network address. So possibility of entering wrong IP address by the typing mistake, or maybe when you read something, then you type something. Possibilities there are. Even I put a 2 so many times. When I type here, I put a 2. When I type here, I put a 2 here. So possibility wrong IP address also assigning. So and administrative burden also increases. Okay. So for example, more number of PCs are there, admin button will be increases. How to spell button? Administrative button will also increases. So see this one. Reduce the complexity amount of administrative work by using automatic IP configuration. Administrative work will also increases. In a manual, type IP address manually. Typically, incorrect IP address is possible. Incorrect IP address can result is in a possible communication and network issues. Frequent computer moves increase the administrative effect. Another one is also there, guys. When I move this lab, I connected this laptop, I got IP address according to my network, right? And when I go to my office, I will get another IP. But if I use a manual, then if I go to my office, then I have to change my IP address again. So I have to ask my admin, sir, what IP you are using? Then I have to change the IP address. And if I'm using IP address which is already existing in that network, conflict will occur. Okay, I'm going to Hyderabad, I connect my laptop. So what happened? Again, conflict will occur. Or maybe I need to get IP address. So how to send IP address? Ask administrator in that place. I went to my hometown. Again, I have to configure manually. So this is the extra, right? So what is the advantage of automatic IP address or a DHCP? Supply IP address automatically. So you need to configure automatically, you will get IP address. Ensure correct configure information. So obviously it knows what IP address given to the client. So it will give you available IP address only. For example, I am distributing tokens. I have 100 tokens and then I am distributing to everyone. So already once I assigned, one token is already assigned, like 1, 2, 3, 4 I assigned. So which is available, I will give it like a movie tickets. Once, you book the ticket. So when you book the ticket, you will get a row number, seat number, right? A1, A2, A3, G1, G2, F3, like that is of seat numbers are there, row number and seat number, right? So once it is given to someone, they won't give same thing to others, right? So because conflict will occur. So they have a update on a system. So which one is there are given. Even if you want to book a ticket from Book My Show just before half an hour or 1 hour, you can't book it. Why? Because of they'll sync all the online things before 1 hour only, and you want to go to movie just before half an hour before, you have to go to theater and you have to book the ticket. Okay, update client configuration automatically. Anything changes, any network changes and also automatically it will update. Eliminate common source of network problems. Okay, whenever you're moving to one place to another place, automatically you will get a IP address. So that is the advantage of DHCP. That is the advantage of your DHCP. So dynamic host configuration protocol, manually we are getting a lot of issues, so that is the solution. Dynamic, it will give you IP address automatically, so it avoid the conflicts. It will give you a correct IP address, correct configuration to the clients. So that is DHCP. If you see this one in the this PPT, you can see if you are not in automatic, so DHCP won't give you any IP address. Next, remember guys, DHCP won't give IP address to anybody. Client has to ask. So you must be a DHCP client, then only you will get it. So here is important story how DHCP works. This is the second one. So in a DHCP, how DHCP works. Actually, there is a big diagram I'm avoiding. I will tell a story and I will tell another story. The second story is a cut shot. First story having a number of statements, like a more thing there. Same thing with a simplicity. Here it is. This is my DHCP client, means client. DHCP client means who required an IP address. DHCP server, who give a IP address. Okay. For example, I'm using a network, right? So 172.16.0 network. Okay, it means, for example, 170.16.0.102. I have only 100 pieces, for example, maybe 50 pieces, 150. Actually, 149 is a 150. So I will 100 to 150, or maybe 101 to 150. I have only 50 pieces. So this is my range. This is my network. This is my network. And this is my range. My DHCP range. Okay. My DHCP range. Okay. Next. Both are in a network, of course. So I'm not putting the network part, but both are in a network. So client don't have any IP address, but DHCP server has the one IP address. DHCP server IP address is there, right? I'm taking directly from my network only. So this is what I am going to do configuration. So this is my DHCP server IP. Okay. This is server IP. Okay. Now, this is a client. Now, client should have an IP address, right? What is the client IP address? No IP address. Now, client has to ask DHCP server. Client don't have any IP address. Client is asking DHCP server. Okay, actually it will broadcast to, means it will ask everyone. It will ask everyone who are connected in the network. Okay, everyone drop it. So that's why I cut that part. Okay, so if you want to know entire story, there is a previous videos are there, you can watch it. Okay, so client ask DHCP server, first discover it. First it is has to discover who is DHCP server. Okay, first client has to discover it. So it will send a discover DHCP discovery packet. Send DHCP discovery packet to everyone. Okay, so whenever the DHCP received it, whenever the DHCP received discovery packet, then it will reply. Then it will reply to the client. Okay, I'm a DHCP server. I have these IP addresses and IP address is available for you. For example, 110. Okay, it is offers IP address. It offer an IP address to the client. I have an IP address. Do you want it? It offer the IP address. Offer, generally offer letter means you didn't get a job. Appointment letter means you got a job. You're joining. Offer means I have a job. do you want to work it? You know, actual process of job recruitment is the company has to give you an offer. Okay, first they will give you an offer. You see any company, they give you an offer letter. Offer letter means you does not mean you got a job. Offer letter means I'm giving you an offer. Do you want? That is an offer letter. You have to accept it. If you accept the offer letter, then only you will get an appointment letter. If you don't accept the offer letter, you won't get it. For example, I am working here and now I got a job in another company. For example, I didn't try anything, but a lot of people are calling, but some company asked me like, Latif, we are want to offer a job for you. So what offer, what salary, what is my work? If I like it, then I will accept the offer. Then only I can able to join in the company. Understand? Company has the rules, but that's a different point. And now company is a major part in the sense because we need a job. But actually company will offer a person, we have an opening. This is the responsibility. These are the work and this is just your salary. Do you like it? If I like the job, but I don't like a salary, they said, we'll give you 4 lakhs per annum. I'm getting more than that one. So I said, no, because I want more salary. I want maybe 7 lakhs per annum, maybe 6 lakhs per annum, maybe 10 lakhs per annum. So I will tell, this is my offer. So that is their offer. So I'm negotiating it. So no, I want this kind of job. I will work for 4 hours only. Or maybe I will work on weekdays only, not on weekends. So that is their offer a job and we are agree, then only we can go inside a company, right? So that is offer meaning. It means DHCP give an offer to client. Do you want this IP? I have an IP address. Do you want an IP address? Then client will respond back. Yes, I want this IP address. And it will request it. It will send a request. I want this offer. Then client send an acknowledgement. What is an acknowledgement? Is a complete configuration of IP set. Then client will get a IP address. That is the story. Okay. So I'm going to repeat this one again. Of course, in a starting time, when it is sending a request, it use IP address 0.0.0.0 as IP address, means source IP. And destination IP address. Okay, this is a destination for while it is communicating. Okay, so leave about it and I will tell one kacha story. Just guys, listen now very carefully. Client discover server. Client discovers server. It will send a discovery packet. Discover. Okay, so that is called a DHCP discovery packet. The packet use is a DHCP discovery. DHCP discover. So you can see here the spelling discover. DHCP discover. The packet name is DHCP discover. Next time I don't write a DHCP. A DHCP offer. Server send a offer. Server send offer to DHCP client. So what it will send? DHCP offer. Okay. Again, client receive an offer and send a request. Send a request to DHCP server. Request. DHCP request. And server send an acknowledgement. So this is an IP address, and this is the lease duration, how long we can able to use IP address, that is called a lease duration. You can check it in a IP address, then you can see any lease duration. So this is your IP address, subnet mask, DHCP server, DNS server, and lease duration. So entire information give it to your client only. Okay, now the client is get configured with IP address. Now client has a proper IP address. Okay, so this is called DORA process. This is called a DORA process. I will put in a cap so then you can understand. This is called a DORA process. What is DORA process? Discover, offer, request, acknowledgement. Discover, offer, request, acknowledgement. This is called a DORA process. Okay. So again I will tell that one once we will go here. So I told about what are the issues in a manual and what are the issues will be solved by automatic. So you can see that one on yourself. Okay, but here the process I will explain. This is called a DHCP. What is a DHCP process? Okay, DHCP server, DHCP, the entire process, we call it as a DORA process. The process of DHCP, we call it as a DORA process. What is DORA process? Discover, offer, compulsory guys, everybody able to tell that one in an interview and for me and any. So if you may ask anybody, anytime you should tell that one. What is the DORA process? Discover, offer, request, acknowledgement. So who will discover? So first times. What I'm trying to client server, client side and server side. See, client send a discovery packet. Client discover a server. Server don't discover client. Client discover a server. Okay, now offer. Who will give you offer? Server will give you an offer to the client. Next, client send a request. So how many times I'm repeating? Because that is a very important one. And why important is, yes, yeah, whenever they ask the question, what I'm doing, like this. Okay, so client send a discover, client receive a offer, client send a request, and client receive a acknowledgement. Or you can say client send a discover packet to server, server send a offer to client, client request to the server, server send a acknowledgement to client. So this is called a DORA process. discover, offer, request, acknowledgement. DHCP, Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol. So here is a very big one. Why? Because if you got the question about DHCP, this answer will cover so many things, so much of network related things. DHCP topic is that much important. So I'll go back here, Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol. Okay, and what is the use of Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol? It provides IP address to the clients. What is DHCP? It provides IP address to clients. Okay, so client will get IP address automatically. Client means PC or device, anything. Client get IP address automatically. Okay, so this is the thing you have to tell. What is the DHCP? Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol. It provides IP address to the clients. Client get IP address automatically, so we can avoid the manual configuration here. Okay, so this is for notes. This is a first, these points are important. Okay, next immediately just go to if in case, like they ask a question about DORA, or if they are waiting, understand guys, if they ask question about DORA process or DHCP process, if they ask question DHCP process, or maybe they ask DORA process, so anything, or if they didn't ask, just that they're waiting for your story, then immediately what to tell? The DHCP process is a DORA. DHCP uses DORA process. You can say like the DHCP uses DORA process. DORA, discover, offer, request. Never say stories. You guys understand? Never. I am trying to explain you. So then I told a stories like client discovering, server client, like this. This is what. But in at the time of interview, your words, sentences should be very clear. If you are trying to tell a story, you are not a public speakers, right? So you are not a speakers. We are not a speakers. I am not also a speaker, right? This explanation, it will, I can take a time, but in interview we don't have that one. So you have to give cut short. So again, I'm repeating. DHCP uses DORA process. DHCP use DORA process. Discover, offer, request, acknowledgement. That's it. Still you have a time. Then tell the story in an easy way. Client send a discover packet to server. Server send a offer to the client. The client send a request to the server. Server send a acknowledgement to the client. That's it. Okay, see, clearly tell. So again, I'm repeating, enter DHCP. I don't know who is lucky person, who is not lucky person. Who is lucky? Who got the question DHCP? And who is not lucky? Who cannot able to tell answer in a DHCP? That's the two things. Okay, so again, we'll repeat, like DHCP, Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol. It provide IP address to the clients. It give IP address to the clients. Same thing. It client get IP address automatically from DHCP server. Client get IP address automatically from where? From DHCP. Okay. Next, DHCP uses DORA process. What is DORA? Discover, offer, request, acknowledgement. Okay. If you have a time to explain, like they are asking for explain the DORA process. Client send a discover packet to server. Server send a offer to client. Client send a request to server. Server give an acknowledgement to client. So then client will configured with IP address. Client get configured with IP address. So that's it. Client get configured with IP address. So you have to try yourself, then you will understand this one. Okay, so this is the DORA process. So you have seen this one. So I'm in our network. I'm using a practical. We'll see. Okay, 170.16.0.0/16 means I'm using a class full network only. Okay, and my range is 172.16.0.101. So I will start with 101 to 16.0.150. For example, I have 50 systems. This is the range. This is the range. Range. This is the starting IP. This is ending IP. Starting, ending. This is the thing. Okay. Now, what is my DNS server address? What is my DNS server address? 172.168.116.0.254. Okay. Of course. What is my server address? Everything is same here. Everything is same. DHCP server, Active Directory server, everything I am using here only. But I just I try to separate it. Okay. Now where we have to verify in a client only. Okay. So we'll see that one. How to do it? First of all, go to Server Manager. Okay. Add roles and features. Add roles and features is there. Add roles and feature. Next, next, next. Okay. Under roles, you have to select DHCP. Okay. Next, next, next. Install. There no need to do anything. Just install. And there is a blue color mark will be there. So there is underline. So select the underline and configure. Okay. After that one, we have to do configuration. So this is a starting. But remaining I will show you on step by step. So I'm going to the client, guys. Ready for a DHCP? Admin@123. This is my server manager. My server manager, and go to local server. Okay, this is my IP address. So I have to create DHCP in a same network only, not in different network. Check your network, and based on your network only, you should do it. So go to manage, add roles and features. Add roles and features. Click it. Then before you begin is there now. So go to next, next, next. Then in the roles, under roles, go to DHCP server. This is the description of DHCP server. Check mark. Then you will get add features. Click on add features. Okay. Next. 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 Select this option. OS and install. That's it. This is how we can able to install a DHCP server. Just we are installed a DHCP server, but we have to configure it. Okay, so the last check mark is certain services need a restart after installation. For example, Hyper-V. For example, Hyper-V. Today I thought morning I complete DHCP DNS also. Afternoon I will touch the storage. But now it is impossible now. It is possible. It's not happening. That's it. Again, tomorrow morning 10 o'clock only. Mostly I don't want to late. So you get ready by 9:30, 10. So you have to start the practical from 9:30. Check it. Check all the previous notes by 9:30. So be at the system at 9:30. If any changes, that's still you are studying, right? So that is important. Okay, so 10 o'clock we'll start. We'll complete first how much we can able to complete by tomorrow morning about storage. So I will show you all the storage part. Then we'll see the virtualization. Storage, virtualization, Python is also there. So when we will do all these things? We'll see. Till 17th we have a time. Let it install. Relax. Sit back. Practical is will take at least 5 to 10 minutes total. The practical is very small practicals only, but in Windows Server theory is a big one. The point wise explanation is very important. Anyone tell what is Dora process? Meantime, guys, what is Dora? Only 4 letters. I don't want an enter.
Discover.
Very good. Discover.
Discover, offer, request, acknowledgement.
Very good. That's it. Last time one girl told for interior, dynamic offer, request, acknowledgement. And the interior said, "No, it's not dynamic. But, what really it's dynamic?" And she said, "It's a dynamic only." Later she realized it's not dynamic. It is a discover. No, unless sometimes it is okay. She got selected. That's a different point, but very good. It was very simple. Just read it, and you can, if you repeat, and he will give an answer. That is simple. Okay, guys, it is installed. Then go to complete DHCP configuration. So can you see this blue line? So click on this blue line. Complete DHCP configuration. Just click on it, and wizard will start. And this wizard will create two groups. One is a DHCP administrator group, another one is a DHCP user group, and also it will authorize your DHCP server if domain join authorize the DHCP server. So that one second, I will put it in a full screen. Next, now it is asking for a authorization. Which account you want to authorize your DHCP server? Commit. I will explain that what that is authorization, but these two things are done. Creating a groups and as well as the DHCP server. Close. Done. This part is done. Then I'm going to tools, DHCP. And this is a server name, right? IP address, IPv4, address scope. Okay, so DHCP. You can see the name IPv4, address scope. If you want to do for IPv6, this is IPv6. We didn't discuss IPv6, right? We will discuss. We don't know when. Okay, I'm going. IPv4, right click, new scope. Okay, next, I want to give a scope name, any scope, scope one, any name, description, anything you can give, no problem, any name, just a name that is. Okay, this is start IP, end IP. What is my start IP? 172.16. 0.101. This is starting IP. Next, 172.16.0.150. Just for example. And automatically, when I give this IP, and automatically length is came. What is 16? /16 is there, no? That is /16. This is subnet mask. Automatically it came. So you don't need to do anything. Just give the range. This is a exclusion and delay. What is that exclusion? Exclusion means I have a certain IP address that is already in use. So I don't want to give that kind of IP address. For example, already your PC statically it is configured. Right? Already one PC in the network, it configured statically. So I don't want to give that IP to another PC dynamically. conflict will occur, right? So I don't want to give. So that kind of IP I will exclude it. I don't want to give. Exclude means I don't want to give these IP addresses to my clients. So that exclusion must be in your range only. That exclusion must be in a your range only. Maybe in a future, certain IP addresses you may use. So you can able to create a exclusion. Okay, these kind of IP address, I will use it. So I don't do it. Or maybe, when I attend a classes for a server 2003, I learned 2003 only. Remaining I practiced and taught to the people, okay? I learned 2003, but I teach 2008, 12 and 16 now. 19 not get chance. Okay, so I install and I check it. 16, 19, 12, no differences, only few little bit. Okay, but here see, the excluded IP addresses won't give it to clients. I want to exclude first 5 IP addresses to see what is it. In my range, what is my first one is 101. And I want to exclude first 5. Just for understanding only. It's not compulsory. 105. Right. Okay. As my when I learn or the trainer told one example, like there is a system is getting an IP address or some kind of IP address. Always when they got one that IP address, they got a problem to the PC. So something just for funny, like lucky unlucky IP addresses also there, right? So lucky numbers, the number won't give you any luck, okay, but lucky numbers are there. Like I want to reserve that IP, so then I don't want to give them. Just for example, I have a boss, then my boss is like 123 number, okay? No one should get 123. No one should get 123. He want 123. So then I will exclude only one single IP also. So why I'm doing this one? I can give a range of IP addresses like 101 to 105 or single IP also. I can able to exclude it. To see that one only, we done that one. It's not compulsory. By default, the lease duration is 8 days. But I am going to remove this 8 days to 10 minutes. 10 minutes is more. It's okay. So I will give you 8 minutes. 8 minutes is better. Okay. So we have to observe few things. That's why 8 minutes. 8 minutes given a lease duration. No one will give 8 minutes. At least give hours or days. I will explain what is the lease duration. You can read this thing also. Okay, I will configure options now. So we have a different options, DHCP, DNS kind of stuff, default route. This is asking for a default gateway. I don't have default gateway, so I'm not giving. This is my DNS address, and by default it took the name and number also. So you don't have to do anything. It is there already, DNS address. This is Win server. We don't have Win server here. Windows Internet Naming Service. It is a DNS server, but Windows related. DNS server is an open protocol. Next, finish, completed. Okay, just refresh once. Just refresh. Okay. If you got a green check mark, means good. If you got some different mark, then refresh it. Okay, then you will get a green check. If you have any another problem, then different troubleshooting is there. Then you have to go to refresh, all task, restart. Okay, like that. But now it is not required, just refresh. This is your scope. This is your scope. The scope name is scope 1. This is address pool. 101 to 150, total address range. Excluded range is 101 to 106, sorry, 105. So 123 is also excluded. This is an address lease. If you see, if a user got an IP address, a user got an IP address, their client IP address and system name and lease expiration will be noted here. Reservation. For example, I have a PC, they want to get IP always a particular IP address only. They can have a reserve the IP address. Now we'll see the outside of client side, then we'll discuss the remaining thing. Login, anyone, no problem. Now I have to go to ncpa.cpl. I'm in a client. So I got adapter. I open adapter details. So DHCP no means it is a manual IP address. If you see DHCP no means this is a manual IP address. Properties. It is asking administrator password. So give administrator because you don't have a tries to do. Admin address 123. IPv4, select IPv4 properties. So it is already manual configuration. I'm changing to automatic. First one is automatic, and this is also automatic. So that's it. Change from second to first in the client. Okay. Close it. Why it is taking time? Yeah, it is done. Details. Now I got a DHCP enabled S means it's a automatic IP address. IPv4 address is 172.16.0.106. Subnet mask. DHCP server. DNS server. Default gateway is not showing here because I didn't give it. I don't have it also. And this is the lease duration, lease obtained and expiry, when you got a lease and when it is going to be expired. I will explain the lease duration, but see the timing. There is a 8 minutes difference between obtained and expiry. 8 minutes are different. Okay, so 8 minutes is the life of this IP address. Okay, that is the lease duration. I will explain it. It is not permanent life kind of stuff. There is another things also there. Okay. When you click on properties, if it is you are getting like this, means administrator, administrator that 123. This is a domain admin you have to give. You don't have rights. So we got successful, but I am going to client. Go to lease, address lease, refresh, go to refresh. See, 106, this is the client name, and this is the expiry time. So your DHCP server, note down who got a IP address from the server. Who got the IP address from the server? It will note down under address lease. So this is the practical. Okay. So this is it.